what has taken some time out from his acting schedule in New York to see a group of young people that he really appreciates. He knows about the Nolan Mighty Ghost, the movie We Got Me, and he's so happy to be here, as well as you're going to love to see this young man who you've seen in many different movies.
Mr. Marc John Jefferies. much I think I'm going to be sure. How is everybody this morning? Okay. Cool, cool, cool. Hey, this is my first time out to Jersey. I'm not going to lie, I was a little afraid. And I was like, Eastside High School, yeah, that's the kind of school. The kid that beat up Cat Williams, he don't go there, right? Because I think after every celebrity saw that, we got the gym, we start taking karate, martial arts, that just could not happen. My name is Marc John Jefferies. As you see, I'm an actor. I'm also an entrepreneur. I own a few businesses, restaurants. I have my own acting academy in New York City. I'm just a young dude that's focused and trying to grow, taking strides every step of the way. I came out here because I wanted to talk to y'all about a few things. One thing that's very important to me, I would say communication and image. You know, in today's society, I feel that a lot of people don't really understand how important both of those things are in being successful. So we're going to get into that briefly. I am from the Bronx, New York. Anybody here from New York? Oh, what? You got like two people. That's crazy. Oh, I know you. You work in a Spanish restaurant. I'm one step near. Yeah, primo. Nah, I'm glad. But yeah, I'm from the Bronx, New York. I was born and raised on 164 on Woodcrest Avenue. I grew up in the Bronx, I moved to Pennsylvania, California to pursue work and things like that. I was homeschooled, I graduated at 16 years old. I applied to Fordham University in Juilliard for performing arts. After I was accepted but wasn't able to attend due to shooting movies, I reapplied for early child education. My mom is a teacher, she's been a teacher for like 30 years now, so I love like, you know, teaching, helping everybody, doing everything. I shouldn't have said that. She's not dead. She's still alive. When people say that, it makes you think the person passed. But despite all of that, despite my upbringing, despite where I'm from, here I am. Alright? Have you guys ever heard the saying that a person is a product of the environment? Y'all ever heard that? Okay, cool. I feel like that's true to a certain extent. You know, I feel that where you're from and the people you associate yourself with, it can definitely mold you to become good and productive or to be bad and just be a part of the streets that you come from. But that's not always the case. My mom has been a teacher for 30 years. She has a master's in criminal justice, a master's in sociology, and a master's in early child education. She is from Brownsville, Brooklyn. Y'all know what that is, Brownsville? Y'all know the reputation for Brownsville? Unfortunately, both of her parents were drug addicts. They passed when she was 16. She is the oldest of four. She tried to get custody of her three brothers after her parents passed, and they didn't give them, so they were thrown into the system, mixed up and everything like that. Now, despite that situation, my mom had knowledge. She had a desire to do more than what she saw around her, and she worked on becoming it. I'm a young kid from the Bronx. Most kids from the Bronx, they're not doing anything for themselves. But because of my parents installing in me the importance of growing and becoming something, and working towards something, and taking yourself seriously, here I am, fortunately. I want to really speak to you guys about communication first, all right? Communication is very important. We got mics? Y'all want to answer some questions for me before y'all? We got some mics? Can somebody tell me what communication is to you? What does it mean to communicate? Right there. Can you tell me? What's your name, bro? Well, you got like a mic. I'm talking to you like you're dancing. She said, like, she's about to drop some fire. All right, drop the tea. Okay, that is one form of communication, that's true. Can anybody tell me what's another form of communication? Anybody? Or what it means to communicate? Alright, I'm just answering, because y'all being shy. To communicate, it means to display or share news or emotion with another person in a way that they can understand. Marc John Jefferies.
Thank you for tuning in to Eastside Writing.